do remember the outbreak of war. I was playing in the garden and we came in. My mother was sitting shelling peas around the radio, by the radio, and we heard the announcement of war. That I remember very clearly indeed, because everybody was extremely serious. I remember going back out with my brother in the garden and talking about it, and we didn't know what it would mean exactly, except my brother used to know everything and informed me we would have bombs immediately hitting us. Two of us were extremely close. He was very, very possessive and very, very much looked after me. I became very much his best friend and he my best friend. I miss him dreadfully since he died. We used to play a vast imaginary game with an imaginary land with two places on it. There was Argos and Grenville with the two towns on it. I went to school very early. I went very early when war broke out because my mother was a nurse and she had to go into nursing, so she stayed and did the district nursing locally, so young unmarried women could then go away into the services to be nurses in the hospitals which were set up. I remember first going to school, arriving and finding, being very surprised indeed, that not everybody else could read. I was reading at three and a half. I met people who I've been friends with all my life. This is where I met Jill, who married my brother finally, Jill Jenkins as she was then, and my best friend was Christine Hearn, who lived down the road from us. But many other friends did I make at that time, who I kept with all my life. It was extraordinary. Tony Lloyd was at Heathbrow School. It was a funny school, funny little school. I would have liked to have been an architect. It was pointed out to me that I had not done the subjects that I would have had to have done to become an architect. There were two or three things. One, acting, of course. And in fact, I did get a place at the Royal Academy of Dramatic Art, but I was talked out of going there by everybody. Teaching was very much my fourth choice, actually. The other thing I always wanted to do and still want to do and still intend, believe it or not, to do more of is writing. I love writing. So in the end, I went teaching, which I didn't want to do, but there we are. I didn't teach. I met Peter, well, in the Young Conservatives. He was the divisional chairman. He came from the Tring lot, and I, at that time, was living in Hemel Hempstead. It was part of the Hemel Hempstead Young Conservatives. So I was became the secretary of the divisional Young Conservatives, and Peter was the president of the divisional Young Conservatives. We went to the conference at Scarborough. I had a bedroom to myself, which was tiny, but Peter was sharing with Chris Grenside. Peter had got some function in London. He wasn't arriving till late. This place insisted on locking its doors up at some very early hour. I said I would sit up and open the door for him because he wasn't going to be arriving till 2 o'clock. So they presented me with an alarm clock before I went to bed. Duly did he arrive at 2 o'clock, and I sort of let him in. Chris Grenside in the meantime had said, oh, Rosty can stay outside in his car all night. But that was the first time really I think we sort of met. Peter would bring me back after we'd been out quite late, and that the lights would always be on in the house when we used to get there. We used to go in and my father would be waiting, reading a book, ostensibly, and he would say the same thing each time. Oh my goodness, is it that time? Is it that late? Oh, it's not that late, is it? Do you care for a game of chess? We'd been skiing, my first time skiing to Davos. So Peter suddenly asked me to marry him at a petrol station in Bruges in the pouring rain. And it wasn't till later I realised it was April the 1st, but there we are. I presume he meant it, because I accepted at that point. And he always assumed I meant it, I presume, too. Well, we went on our honeymoon. We did a massive, great tour. We went all round. We started off in France. We then went on down into Italy. And unfortunately, we spoke no Italian. So we managed until we got to Rome. We then saw a place which said, rooms to let. We translated that, was fine. So Peter went over and negotiated a room, and she asked him how long. And when he said 2 or 3 days, she gave him a rather strange look. It was when we came back in the evening after our meal and discovered that the whole of the front of the parlour of the house that you went into at the bottom was all suffused in a sort of orangey-red light, and Madame, who was our lady, was sitting at a desk in the corner, and all round on these benches were these rather voluptuous-looking young ladies, all sort of semi-clad, that we then realised that we scuttled across what sort of a place we'd rented rooms in, and that when she said rooms to rent, it meant by the hour and not by the day. When we first got married, we lived at in Chelsea in a flat. Well, obviously, we wanted a place of our own. We saw Norcott, but it was ridiculously expensive. 5.5 years later, the house was still unoccupied, and he dropped the price properly. We bought